keto diet, or you've been living a low-carb lifestyle for a while now, you're probably on the continual hunt to find new keto recipes. That's where I come in. This channel, plus my website, KetoFocus.com, you're gonna find some of your keto comfort food favorites on there. Plus, I like to create simple, easy keto recipes for the busy family. So today, if you're on the lookout for some more recipe ideas, well, I'm gonna show you five must-have keto recipes that you need to make. Like always, before we get started, make sure you guys subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so you get notified every time I post a new recipe. First up is keto pizza. Yes, you can actually have pizza on the keto diet, and there's lots of different variations and recipes out there. And I have quite a few on my website too. Just Google Keto Focus pizza and you're gonna pull them all up. I show you how to make grilled pizza, there's breakfast pizza, and just some different various toppings that you can throw on pizza too, plus my basic keto pizza crust recipe. This recipe is a fathead dough pizza. It's delicious. It tastes like regular pizza crust. It bakes like regular pizza crust. It's thick and chewy and has this perfect crust on the outside. It looks like a pizza crust too. It's fabulous. You guys have to try it. So I'm gonna have it listed down below. So the link's gonna be down there so you can click on that to find the recipe on my website. Also, I have several videos on it. So I'll link that up here if you wanna click on my keto pizza playlist. You can check that out. Basically, my keto pizza fathead dough recipe involves melted mozzarella cheese, almond flour, egg, baking powder, and xanthan gum. It's just all those ingredients mixed together, rolled out into a pizza crust, and you pile on your favorite toppings. Keto pizza really is not that hard to make. The hardest part is probably trying to make up the dough, which a little pro tip here, you can make it up ahead of time. It's one of the things that I like to make if I'm meal prepping. So if I'm gonna make up a bunch of pizzas, I'm gonna probably double or triple my recipe. And then you can actually, once you roll it out, you could store them flat as a pizza crust and freeze it before you bake it. Or you can just store it in like a disc shape or a ball shape and keep that in the freezer. And so then when you do wanna have pizza later on in the week, you just take out your dough, let it thaw out at room temperature, or let it thaw out in the refrigerator. And then when it comes dinner time, it's easy to make pizza. Another recipe that you have to try on the keto diet is lasagna. So yes, there's actually keto lasagna recipes out there too. So Italian food is not off limits on the keto diet. You just have to kind of substitute a few ingredients here and there. So when it comes to lasagna, there's different types of recipes, like I said. A lot of them will use like zucchini, sheets of zucchini, or cabbage as noodles. I don't really like to use those because I feel like it makes the lasagna soggy. Plus it alters the taste a little bit too, and the texture is not quite the same. I like to keep things simple. So what I use is actual slices of deli meat. So deli turkey or deli chicken works really good. Just the type that you would get at your deli counter, just tell them to slice it off pretty thin for you. And that works as a noodle. These are called protein noodles too. And it's very, very easy. You just layer them down along with your layers of lasagna. So I'll make up a meat sauce too, with some marinara sauce and some ground beef in there. And then my white sauce, I usually like to use ricotta cheese just to keep it simple. You could use cream cheese if you want, or make up your own white sauce that's keto approved. And then just do your layers of red sauce with the cheese and ricotta cheese, and then you're just layer down your slices of deli meat on as your noodles. And these noodles work perfectly. Like if you feed this to your family that is not keto, they will not be able to tell the difference because the texture, it actually cooks up the same and it has a good flavor too. So it doesn't have any sort of weird vegetable-y or cabbage flavor like you would if you're going to use cabbage or zucchini. And I have this recipe on my website as well. Just Google KetoFocus lasagna and you'll find it. I'll have it linked down below for you too, and make sure you click on that video up here if you want to watch how to make it. Up next is the chaffle. So if you're new to the keto diet, you might not have heard of what a chaffle is. If you've been around a while, you know they were super, super popular last year. They still are very popular. Basically, a chaffle is a keto waffle that's primarily made up of egg and cheese. I like to throw in other ingredients in there too, like almond flour or maybe some coconut flour and baking powder. Those just give them some stability. Gives it a little bit more meat when you hold on to it. And it doesn't make it so it tastes more like an egg and cheese. It kind of just drowns out those flavors a little bit. And the great thing about chaffles is that it's a versatile recipe. So you can do different flavor combinations. Like my basic keto waffle chaffle combination is just to add one egg, a half of a cup of mozzarella cheese, shredded mozzarella cheese, 2 tablespoons of almond flour, and then a half a teaspoon of baking powder. You mix it together and put it in your waffle maker. But if you wanted to make up some different variations, you could add some cocoa powder to make a chocolate chaffle or some peanut butter to do a peanut butter chaffle. Also, I know it's pumpkin season coming out, so you could add some pumpkin and some pumpkin spice in there and make a pumpkin spice chaffle. And chaffles aren't just for breakfast. Like, they do make a great keto breakfast option. It is something that you can prep up ahead of time too. I know a lot of people who make them up ahead of time, big batches of them, and they store them in big giant canisters and freeze them, or just store them in the refrigerator for later. So you could certainly do that if you are more of the meal prep breakfast type. I just kind of like to make them on the fly because it really doesn't take that long to make. But you don't have to eat them just for breakfast. Like, I like to make them with sandwiches. I use them as sandwich bread. So I have a recipe for a Wonder Bread chaffle on my website. It's delicious. It tastes just like white bread, so you could have that as an option. You could also make stuffing with chaffles. I like to use it as the bread substitute in a keto stuffing recipe. And I've also made cakes using chaffles too, like my famous birthday chaffle cake, which I'll have linked up here for you guys. The next keto recipe that you must try is an egg roll in the bowl. So if you've ever been on Pinterest just Googling up some keto recipes, you've probably run into this one. It's a very popular recipe on the keto diet because it has all those Asian, yummy Asian flavors, and it's simple to make. I finally recreated my own version of a keto egg roll in a bowl, so I'm gonna share that with you now. In a large skillet, we're gonna add 1 pound of ground pork, and you wanna cook that until it's done. And then we're gonna add in some whites of a bundle of onions. So I've just taken a bundle of onions and chopped off the white parts and diced those up. And I'm gonna throw that into my skillet along with some garlic paste and ginger paste. You can use minced garlic cloves here if you want to. This would be around 3 minced garlic cloves or about 1 inch worth of ginger if you wanted to grate that and put that in there. I like to use a shortcut and use the ginger paste and the garlic paste that I find in the grocery store. You wanna cook this all up for about a minute, and then we're gonna add in some mushrooms. This is around 4 ounces of mushrooms going in here. And then coleslaw. I'm gonna use bag coleslaw. This is actually just straight cabbage. I don't really like to get the stuff that has the carrots in it just because I wanna have as minimal carbs as possible, but you could definitely use the coleslaw mix with the carrots and the red cabbage in it too. Or you could just take some cabbage and slice it up yourself and throw it in there. You're also gonna add 1/4 cup of liquid aminos. This is gonna be our replacement for soy sauce. Soy sauce does have a small amount of carbohydrates in it, so most people try to avoid soy sauce. You don't have to. If that's all you have on hand, then just add in 1/4 cup of soy sauce. 2 tablespoons of white vinegar, 1 tablespoon of sesame oil, 1 teaspoon of monk fruit. And you don't have to add in the monk fruit. I just like to have a little bit of sweetness in here. It just really balances out the flavor. You want to cook this, stirring it until the cabbage has softened. Then just remove it from the heat, and then you can add some green onions in. So this is the top part of that bundle of green onions that we diced up earlier. And I like to top my egg roll in a bowl with sesame seeds and a mixture of sriracha mayo. So my mixture of sriracha mayo, I usually use around a quarter cup of mayonnaise with a tablespoon of sriracha sauce. And I know sriracha sauce does have carbohydrates in it. You could just omit this step or maybe use hot sauce instead. And that's it. This is a super easy keto recipe you can make for dinner or lunch. You can prep this up ahead of time, pack it in some little containers and take it with you to work if you're looking for an easy meal prep recipe for lunches. Or like I said, just make it up for your family for dinner time. It's delicious. And of course, I have to share with you guys a dessert recipe. So one of the must-have keto recipes that you have to make if you're gonna be on the keto diet is a mug cake. And I have a basic chocolate mug cake recipe for you guys today. This thing is delicious, plus it takes around a minute to make. Most keto recipes start by just adding all of your ingredients to a mug and then microwaving it. I like to use ramekins instead when I'm making my mug cake just because they're thicker and they have an even thickness around it. So you're gonna get even baking when you use one of these. Sometimes if you just use a mug, you might have one area that's fully cooked and maybe another area that's kind of mushy. So this guarantees I'm gonna have even baking through the whole mug cake. So we're gonna add 1 egg, 2 tablespoons of melted butter, 2 tablespoons of almond flour, 2 teaspoons of coconut flour, 1 tablespoon of monk fruit, or you can use a sweetener of your choice, and 1 tablespoon of coconut powder, 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder, and I also like to add in a pinch of salt just to amplify that sweetness. Mix this together and we're gonna pop it in the microwave for around 60 to 75 seconds. And there you go, you have a portion-controlled mini little keto chocolate cake. This thing's delicious. I like to top it with a little bit of whipped cream and some chocolate shavings, and it makes the perfect after-dinner treat. I love mug cakes for the keto diet because a lot of times you don't really want to make up a whole entire recipe if you have a little sweet tooth. You just want to have something, just a little nibble of something, something that's portion controlled so that you're not going to go overboard or so that you're not going to waste up all of your ingredients. So that's where recipes like mug cakes come in. And I have a lot of different mug cake recipes on my website. I'll have a few of them linked down below, or you can just Google search KetoFocus mug cakes. All right, so these are the 5 must-try keto recipes on the keto diet. Let me know down in the comments if you have some other recipes that you think that we should all try. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so you guys get notified every time I post a new video. Have a good one, bye.